mean, I'll do the heart. This time I can fire my hips. Five. What's that gonna do?
Nothing.
Okay. What if I keep my hips stable and simply just shift my weight and use my legs, including my hips, because my base, using the ground, my base is from the hips down. The reason why I know that is because my motor is my core. There's no machine in the weight room that works on your hips. It's core.
Right.
Your hips are for stabilization. And so here I am, okay, and it's dry, and I get my hands in position to let them fly where they want to go. Well, I've already tried doing this.
Yeah.
Doesn't work because it's an engine mount, it's not a power source. But what if here, I'm trying to get okay, that's good. You're trying to get in a better position. But what if all I do is shift with my lower body, stay on the ball? Remember, staying on the ball is what's important. I'm going to only apply centripetal force, which is what we're talking about. Centripetal force is the center seeking rotational force. Okay, I should back up a little bit. Okay, so now we go here, and then we go here, and I rotate. Okay. That's torque. See how much stronger torque is than just a static pull?
You felt it too. I mean, you felt that pull.
Yeah.
Let's
try it again. Okay, so now we're going to try it. We're going to try to see what the centripetal force does. And it's going to what's going to happen is you're going to see centrifugal force in action. Something going out in action. So here I am. That doesn't work. That doesn't work. But if all I do is shift and rotate my core, which is the power source, there you are.